You know, it's good to see a smile back on Cyrus' face.
Still with that phone? We got called out to a hit. Some politician on the take. Now this storm's just raging. And we're driving out the burbs to gap this guy. The street lights weren't so good, so we're driving in the dark. We get to the house, and we're about to make our move. And then there's this lightning flash. And for a split second, in the front yard, I see this head just sitting there, staring, cut off at the neck.
Nah, this ain't true.
Some other crew had already been out to the house that night. Guess the guy had more than his share of enemies. They never found the body.
Bullshit.
Thanks for waiting, Tom. The Don and I had to go over last month's numbers again.
Sure. So what's the job?
I want you to help Sam and Polly with the shipment we've got coming in tonight.
The good stuff?
Straight from Canada.
Where do you need me?
Sam's gone to meet our friends from the north at the farm outside of town. Polly will oversee the trucks bringing the shipment into the city, but I want you to go with him. Be an extra pair of eyes. Make sure it all goes smoothly.
Okay.
Get the car from Ralphie and meet Polly at the warehouse. He's got heaters in case you run into any trouble.
Sure, Frank. No problem.
Good. Now bring the Canadian home safe, Tommy. There is already a case earmarked for the Don.
This mama motor's yours, if you want it, Tommy.
Thanks, Ralph.
Thank you. Come on, Tom! Hey, hey! Watch it, pal. Just dry it out.
Sorry. You know this place?
Yeah. We've done a few pickups at the farm before. Don't worry. There ain't nothing but cow shit and shine out here. It's gonna be an easy few clams. Boys will load up the trucks, and we'll come straight back.
Yeah, let's make it quick. I got someplace to be.
You see it, Sarah, later. Luigi's little girl, your night shift. You're something else, pal. Protecting the girl's virginity one day and taking it the next.
Lay off, Polly.
Come on. I'm just kidding. She's a good girl. You settle down, she'll straighten you right out. You're going home to a couch. Now, I wonder what kind of story she could tell about her old man, though. Luigi was a stone-cold killer back in the day.
I wouldn't know.
You know she's been helping out behind a bar since she was a kid. I bet she's seen and heard a few things. Probably knows more about our business than we do.
She knows enough not to ask me too many questions.
That's good. She won't ever make a liar out of you. Christ. You ought to marry her just for that. Damn it. Sam should be waiting here, but I don't see him.
Something smells off.
Don't let your pecker get all shriveled up. Probably just trying to get out of the rain. Or into the bootleg. That'll wake him.
He ain't coming.
Okay. Let's go find them. That bastard is just three sheets, and I'm wrecking a new suit for nothing. I swear I'm gonna kill him. Here, just in case Frank was right. I'm gonna go grab them boys, get them sorted out. You go ahead, see what's what. We'll catch up with you.
Someone's been waiting here tonight. Guy we pay to keep this place in check. Don't even pretend to farm now. Don't feel right. What kind of guy shoots a dog? This is derelict.
Where the hell are you hiding?
Hey, buddy. Jesus.
Drop your weapon.
You first.
We don't have time for this.
Sorry, pal. Guess we're doing this the hard way.
Okay, then.
Get over here! I got him pinned down!
Not here.
This was a setup.
Nothing about this feels right.
Tom!
Polly! What took you so long?
We're looking for Sammy. Did you find him?
Nah, not yet. Just him.
Canadian crew. Dollars to donuts to rest the face down in the dirt, too. Oh, Christ. Cops, Tommy.
Well, how would I know? They didn't show a badge. God, they didn't say anything.
They must be in Morello's pocket. This bastard. He can't even let us have this one racket. Forget about it, Tom. We gotta find Sam and get out of here.
These guys are the real deal. They gotta be cops from the Border Patrol.
Search the farm, find Sam, get the hell out. Anyone else? We sleep on the farm. Get it?
Sam! Sam! Where the hell are
you? You want to quiet down, Polly?
all shot in the back of the head. Must have been lined up.
Poor bastards.
Border cops doing Morello's dirty work.
Get some cover! Thank Christ. We gotta get to him.
Stay here and watch our backs. Plug anyone who gets within 100 yards. Except us. Okay, just hang on. I'll go get the truck, then we'll take you to the doctor. Hey, hey, you're gonna make it, Sam. Tommy, stay here with him. I'll be back. I'll be back in a flash.
Okay. Fuck! Hey, it'll be okay, Sam. We survived worse.
You sure we have?
Where'd all these guys come from?
Well, Zena!
Take them down, Tom!
Andy, now!
Jesus Christ! Where's the goddamn truck?
Crap, we got cops!
Thank you.
Christ. Tony and Donnie too?
Yeah.
What a fucking massacre. How's Sam?
Well, he ain't any worse.
I'll go get him. Keep an eye out.
Company.
All right, get in.
Okay. I'm right here, Sam.
There's some ammo and a Thompson back there somewhere. When they pull in behind you, blast them to hell. Just don't let them get past us.
We need to go now!
them!
We did it! We did it!
Okay, we're here. Tom, you get Sam out. I'm gonna go wake up the doc.
Sam, Sam. We made it. We're at the doctor's house.
Three, I owe you.
Paulie, what the hell are you doing here so late?
Evening, Doc. Sorry to wake you, but we had a little accident. We got an injured man out here.
All right, bring him inside.
Okay, thank you. Okay, I'll stay with Sam. You can take the truck back. Call it a night.
No, I'll wait.
The doc's already got his hands full. No sense in both of us breathing down his neck.
Go on, Tom. I'm gonna be fine.
Okay.
Hey, you did good tonight.
Economists, who insist that things must run their course and that human agencies can have no influence on economic ills. One reason is that I happen to know that professional economists have changed their definition of economic laws every 5 or 10 years, for a very long time. But I do have faith, and retain faith, in the strength of common purpose, and in the strength of unified action taken by the American people.
The president there speaking earlier this year on the National Recovery Administration.
You're late. Dinner's cold.
Work.
Hey, Bass. They came as soon as I got your message.
Sit down, Tom. We have a mole, Tom.
No. Who?
I was up all night driving myself nuts trying to figure it out. Started thinking maybe it's one of our guys. We aren't paying his fair share. Someone with a light wallet.
Maybe looking to Morello for a new suit.
Frank wasn't around, so I went to the safe to get the account books. To see who's getting cents on the dollar he's earned.
What do you know?
The books are gone, Tom.
Frank.
More than 50 years I've known him. Everything I have, I got with Frank. And every buck we've earned, every dime we've paid out, it's all logged in those books. Frank hands those over to the feds, we're finished.
Frank respects one person in this whole town, and that's you. This has got to be some kind of misunderstanding.
I've been calling him all day. I went by his place. He's gone. His wife and kid are gone.
But why?
I don't know. I'm sure he has his reasons. Maybe he's still smarting over the dog.
The one you tried to drown?
Yeah. Same one I shot after he wouldn't let me sink her. I was a stupid kid, Tommy. But grudge or no grudge, we gotta get those books back. Shake down all our stories. See who knows what. When you catch up to Frank, you get those books. And if he doesn't have them on him, you make him tell you where to find them. After that, you do what we gotta do.
Vincenzo's waiting for you with a clean car. Last I saw Frank, there was no sign of this. We had a drink, talked business. Now this.
Tommy. Tough day today, Tom.
We gotta keep a lid on this, Tom. Start with Biff, but don't give him nothing. I got your clean set of wheels. And something special here, if you want it. When Frank sees a La Para, he'll know. The old ways work. Whatever it takes, Tom.
Sorry.
Hello? Yeah, we got trouble.
Collision in Chinatown. Officers required.
Must have snuck away.
Tommy, what's the rumpus?
Heard any big news lately? Something that Don might want to know.
Depends. What's it worth to you?
$20.
How about 40?
All right, spill.
The FBI's in town. They're getting something from Morello, but I don't know what.
How'd you hear?
Little Tony got some guy drunk in the Black Cat and drove him home. Heard a bunch of stuff, so he's the guy you want to see.
Okay. Thanks.
Always a pleasure, Tommy.
WLH Sports Report. There's a sense of anticipation as we await the start of the big game. Our very own Lost Heaven Lancers are out on the road, deep in enemy territory as they take on bitter rivals, the Empire Bay Cannons. This year's Gold Series is shaping up to be one of the best on record, with both teams matching one another blow for blow. Despite the Cannons' home field advantage and an early lead in the series, the Lancers have bounced back and have really taken their rivals to task. Many of the plaudits and column inches have been dedicated to one man. Lancers pitcher Bunny Smith is one of this year's standout performers. And with this series tied at 3-3, he may well be the key man that brings the Wistman Trophy back to Lost Heaven. But doing so will be no easy task, as standing in his way is opposition captain, Foghorn Jack Seidel. His solo home run in the bottom of the fifth inning of Game 5 turned events in favor of the Empire Bay team. Victory was canceled out by the Lancers in Game 6, and we now have a powder keg finale that is sure to have everyone glued to their radios. Can Bunny Smith bring it home for Lost Heaven? Or will the Cannon's towering redhead have the final say? WLH 570 Lost Heaven Radio will carry live coverage of the final game of the Gold Series, and we hope you'll join us in...
I said, really? All us guys out here wishing we had a job. And these bozos in the factories think they're owed something. Yeah, that's right.
Everything okay, Tom?
Nah. Nah, it's not. What's this about the guy you drove home who's with the feds?
He came in for a drink, which turned into 10. He's hired muscle for some kind of safe house.
Where?
Oak Hill, corner of Pine. He gave me $10 to drive him back and keep my mouth shut. Let on that Councilor Gilatti's brokered some kind of deal between Morello and the FBI. They were all ready to sit tight on someone in there.
Why the hell didn't you tell us?
Tom, I did. I came in to see Frank straight away. He didn't tell the Don?
No, he didn't.
Tom, what's going on?
Yeah, he's got a job, but it sure ain't legal. Honest work, pay some taxes. I do it all the time.
We return now to the coverage of Game 7 of the Gold Series. And by the looks of it, ladies and gentlemen, we'll be underway any minute now. The crowd here in the Armory are restless. You can almost taste the tension as we approach this, the deciding game between these two famous rivals. More than a little bad blood between them and more than a couple of nasty flare-ups in recent years. Of course, this occasion, more than any other, could prove feisty, what with the drama that closed out the previous game. That, of course, saw the Lancers win to tie the series, and it's not often Empire Bay and Lost Heaven can boast the game's best current hitter and pitcher, respectively. I refer, of course, to Foghorn Seidel, the man mountain with a shock of red hair, and Lancers star Bunny Smith. Speaking of Smith, he is jogging, I suppose you'd say, between his teammates, issuing last-minute orders. They seem responsive to whatever he's saying. He commands respect from his team, that is for sure. By goodness, there must be some nerves among some of the younger Lancers. Elms, Graveson, and Nicholson. Smith seemed to have pepped them up. That's good to see. That's what a good captain does. The cannon's lineup is meandering over to the home team dugout. The Lancers are slowly taking up their position, so we can't be too far away from the opening pitch here at the Armory, the home of the Empire Bay Cannons. Stay with us for more.
The mission of Lost Heaven Radio, our city's public service broadcaster, is to serve you. Start your day with WLH 570. Empire Bay is no longer out of reach thanks to Blue Heron Airlines.
Yes, we need help right away.
Officers downtown. Some fella near you is driving like a madman.
There he is.
Officers have seen him. Now in pursuit. Okay, arrest the guy.
Well, I can't give up.
Yeah, the suspect's been lost downtown. We'll find him. Search is called off. Repeat, abandon search. Return to patrols.
Carry-on hotels open again after the gas leak. Get your paper.
Looks like the place. Take me to those account books, Frank.
The series between the Lost Heaven Lancers and the Empire Bay Cannons. A quick reminder that this final inning is being brought to you by Swift Cola. When you need a lift, reach for a Swift. It's not only a taste sensation, it's guaranteed to increase focus, drive, and mental clarity. Pick up a bottle of Swift Cola today. And as we are coming to a close, let me thank today's other sponsors, Big Break Cigarettes and Lost Heaven Courier. Both of these teams could be said to be entering golden eras. Each team has a star player at the core with promising youngsters set around them. I refer, of course, to Smith and Seidel. The Cannons have had several such golden periods. The Lancers, it's fair to say, have not. I can see Lancers manager Frankie Hodge prowling in front of the dugout, gesticulating. He seems animated, to say the least. Looks like he's putting one of the officials in his place or something or other. With the noise of the crowd, it is quite hard to say for sure. Whatever's going on down there, you can feel the sense of occasion, and you just know that whatever happens, the crowd will be the first to tell you what has happened. The Lancers are now within minutes of snatching the Gold Series, which at one stage had appeared doomed, but they equally teeter on the edge of defeat. It all comes down to the final play. Nobody is warming up in the bullpen. Nobody down there is considering the possibility of extra innings. Bunny Smith then, standing on the mound, a look of steely determination on his face. He's betraying no emotion, doesn't look nervous or tired after his exertions this series, nor does he appear to be carrying the weight of expectation.
Gotta be some kind
He's
of meat happening.
He's having a war with the about something or other. What a strapping fellow. 6'2", 195 pounds. If the Lancers are to win here today, he's going to write himself into the record books. And boy, oh boy, what that would mean to the people of Lost Heaven after such a long time without glory on the diamond. All right, they've sorted out whatever was going on. Here we go then. In for the Cannons, it's Paddy Dougherty. Smith is pitching the game of his life, but Dougherty's a big man. If he can catch one, it could run, and with bases loaded, the Cannons could have it. Here we go. Dougherty facing down Smith. Fastball and strike. The big man thought he had it. Some speed on that ball. My goodness. It's fair to say Dougherty looks a little spooked. He was convinced he had it. His body language tells the tale. Smith remains cool under pressure, not a flicker of emotion on his face. He winds up. And that's two. There was zip on that one. Good Lord. Seidel is barking something at Dougherty, but we have no chance of hearing it as the noise of the crowd reaches fever pitch. Dougherty's gesturing, and that's only making Seidel more irate.
They're taking you to the airport, Frank.
This is it, folks. Another strike, and the Lancers win. If Dougherty can get behind it, surely the Cannons will get all their men home and snatch victory.
We need help right away. A single miss. Coach Schultz heard. Please respond.
Lancers win! Lancers win! And Smith finally cracks an elated smile. He's thrown his cap in the air, as have his teammates. Lancers win the 1933 Gold Series!
All officers, search is called off. Repeat, abandoned search. Return to patrols.
Christ, they're flying him out of state or something. Fuck, this ain't good. Christ, they're flying him out of state or something. Fuck, this ain't good.
authorities people, the FBI.
Guy just flashed a badge at me and forced me out.
Hides will be canceled, for sure.
The plane they're gonna use is Don Morello's. I'm sure of it. Told me nothing.
We've kept a lid on this so far. Let's get it done quietly and go home.
What?
Show his face
for a rat like you? Nah. Get in the car. Corruption, smuggling, prostitution. Looks too big to throw out.
We're getting a case. I see her!
Hey!
See him?
Get a better shot. Go!
Get cover. You're in sights. Hey, I'm here. Where's our punk?
What?
I'm out. No. Cover me. He's out. Hit him.
Tom.
Frank. The Don sent me.
I figured as much. I'm sorry it had to be you, Tommy.
Anything you want me to tell him?
I wish it could have shaken out better, but Morello finally came after me. It's okay. You can come out. Morello offered me a simple trade. The Don's account books for our lives and tickets out of this town.
You hand the books over yet?
I'm not so stupid, Don. They're safe. Morello was waiting for this. It's a key to a box in the Grand Imperial Bank downtown. I told Morello I'd hand it over after the plane was fueled and ready to go. His men were meant to fetch it before we left.
I took care of them. Told them to get on a plane.
Go on, March, Alice. Get aboard.
Frank, you're coming with us.
Not right now, honey. Just get buckled in. Tommy and I, we have some serious business to discuss.
But Frank...
Get on the plane, March. For Alice. For me. Get on the goddamn plane, please.
You been paid yet?
Yeah.
Now you've been paid twice. You take the ladies wherever they want to go.
Yes, sir.
Thank you, Tom.
Christ, Frank. Why didn't you ask us for help?
I guess I just wanted out. One way or the other. I'm tired, Tommy. Tired of lying to my wife. Tired of checking under my car every time I take a Sunday drive. And tired of waiting for the Don to put two in my temple.
Damn you, Frank.
Hello there.
Hmm.